In this video, we will be discussing the differences between Bozeman A, Bozeman B, Cotonou, and import type passports. These are extremely crucial when applying for basketball jobs. Whether you're looking for jobs at the highest level or at low to mid levels, it still applies to you. There's always regulations based upon passports. Jean-Marc Bozeman was a Belgian soccer player who really influenced this rule where we see Bozeman A, Bozeman B, and the transfer of players between clubs to other clubs, and the power that players now have, and also the regulations that leagues and teams face. Introduced in 1995 due to three legal cases, the Bozeman rule took effect. It allowed free transfer between clubs of players at the end of contracts without a fee. Clubs could no longer ask for high transfer fees and cut players' salaries. The overall ruling was that the soccer club and the league violated the freedom of movement for workers addressed in the Treaty of the European Union, which allows workers in the European Union of any citizenship, any country, to move freely within there and work without regulation and without restriction. The effect this had on basketball clubs is the same effect it had on soccer clubs and leagues, is that now the power is in the players' hands. Okay, and now you see the emergence of big-time agents, big-time contracts, players getting paid more, and now you see super clubs and teams losing control and not being able to restrict players so much. All of these countries you see in blue are Bozeman A countries, meaning that you can flow from one country to another. Say you were French and you got an offer in a German league, you would not be counted as an import player. You're counted as an EU Bozeman A player, which there are more spots, it's less regulated for a player of EU status as a Bozeman A player to play on a team within that same confines in the EU and not be counted as one of the import players. Why is this important? Because there are import regulations, import rules. A league may only allow one or two imports. This way, you do not take up one of those spots. So take Germany, for example. There are spots designated for Germans. You need local players, okay? And then the rest of your roster can be filled with infinity amount of, up to obviously a certain number, most of the time 12, infinity amounts of European players, and then you're allowed maybe one or two imports. If you are an import player and you have the ability to get a passport in one of these countries, it will greatly increase your chances of getting a position or getting a higher position in a much more competitive league and a much higher salary, okay? So if you have family members down your ancestry where you can, and most all of these countries have some type of program where you can get it through maybe a great grandfather or something like that. Just look it up, go online and check that out, because it can greatly increase your chances and your value on the market as a Bozeman player instead of an import player. Our map here is a very recent map. As you see, the UK is in gray instead of blue. Now, because of the Brexit, that's what has taken the UK out of the European Union. But now they are still treated, when it comes to players, they're still treated as the same, okay? And if you look in the middle there at Switzerland, it's the exact same thing. They have a very powerful passport, a very powerful country, and they do not need any type of special thing. They're not considered Bozeman B, they're considered Bozeman A, okay? Bozeman B countries are Serbia, Turkey, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Montenegro, North Macedonia, Republic of Georgia, Albania, Kosovo, Andorra, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Belarus, Moldova, Monaco, which is the little tiny gray dot you see in between Spain and France, the Ukraine, and as of Norway also, and as of January 31st of 2020, the UK has been taken out of it. But again, some of these countries are still considered, when we talk basketball terms, as a European Union citizen. So Norway would be one of them. Switzerland would be one of them. Iceland would be one of them. I failed to mention that, but that's also on the list in gray. You see there right above Bozeman A. And now there are a lot of candidates that are, see, this is quickly changing. This has expanded greatly from 1957 to what we're looking at today. So the candidates for soon getting their EU membership is Albania, Montenegro, North Macedonia, Serbia, Turkey, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and Kosovo. And all of the Bozeman A countries are what I have not mentioned. So that's all the rest of these EU countries that you see in blue. So if you are not one of, if you're not a passport holder of one of these countries, you are either now considered a Cotonou player or an import player, okay? So next we're going to talk about Cotonou, and at the very end we're going to talk about import players. Cotonou passports refer to the countries that you see in green. A lot of people have ancestry through these. And it is a very powerful passport in the sense that you can be counted, again, not as an import player in a lot of different countries. A few, especially in Europe, are Belgium, France, Germany, Switzerland, and Spain. And these are basically colonized countries from Britain, France, and from the Americas. So if you possess dual citizenship or the ability to get this, this can also greatly enhance your power on the market. So if you're not from one of these countries listed here in green, either in Europe, the Caribbean, Africa, or the Pacific, then you are what's considered an import player, okay? Import players can be Americans, Canadians, Australians, New Zealanders, and this also can change depending on where you're at, right? So if you're in Australia, then an American will still be an import player, but an Australian will be considered a local player. So we have been coming from the reference point of basically playing in Europe, okay? But again, when we talked about the Cotonou passports, if you are an American with dual citizenship from the Caribbean, you may be able to play in an African country or one of the European countries we mentioned that have that agreement with Cotonou passports, okay? So understanding this stuff can be confusing, but it is pivotal, especially when you're looking at increasing your chances of getting a job or getting a higher job in the professional basketball world. Understanding passport power and having the knowledge of being Bozeman A, B, Cotonou, or import is not just common knowledge, okay? It's not a very well-known thing, especially when you're coming out of college basketball as a rookie looking to get overseas. And I see it all the time. When I'm posting a job opening or I see other agents or other people posting job openings for different teams, and it says EU passport holder only, or we need a Bozeman A player, or, you know, Cotonou player accepted. You always see all the time Americans submitting their stuff because they don't know that they don't apply for this. And there's strict restrictions when someone is looking for a job. That means if they can only have an EU passport holder, that means they probably already have the import selected, or they're not looking for that position. They've got that filled, and you are wasting your time. You're looking unprofessional, and you're just going to be skipped over. You're not going to get an explanation why, and you're going to be very confused and probably always applying for jobs that you don't even qualify for. Okay, so if this helped you, please smash that like button and help this get trending on the YouTube algorithm. Because I guarantee if it helped you and you needed this knowledge, somebody else needs it as well. Okay, so please like, please share this and send it to anybody, any players you know that are in need of this information, because it can greatly enhance the chances of somebody getting an opportunity. And that's what this is all about, helping and providing information that I wish I would have known years ago, that it's taken me, you know, a decade of being in international basketball to gather up this knowledge. Okay, so with that said, this concludes this video, and I appreciate your time and you watching. Please consider subscribing. Follow me on social media at CPB Network. That's for Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Also, check out my website, cpbnetwork.com, for more information about this. It's going to be launching soon with our team finder, so we'll, you know, consolidate all types of information and team contacts and country info all in one place for you. The same thing goes for job openings and other type of information, as well as coaching stuff, player stuff, drills, things to get you better, just all around basketball information on the site. So please give it a check. And with that said, you know, have a great day. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.